Hello, what's going on, guys? Zeptrosity here, and it's time for some more modded Skyblock with the Agrarian Skies Hardcore Quest mod pack. What a mouthful that is to say. That is crazy. Alright, anyways, I have been quite busy over there at the tree farm area, but before we do that, a lot of you guys were talking about this certain item, the knapsack. This thing here apparently is super cool. You can see right there, it's got this texture and it fits perfectly in line right here, which is pretty cool. So that is one of these strange little slots here filled. So we can make one of these and basically we can have another inventory. So that would be amazing. And I really have to craft one of these. However, these require leather, and I was like, no, we need leather. And to get leather, well, we know we can kill some cows, but we have no cows here. So yeah, there is a way to get cows though, so we might go into that today. I'm not too sure. There are also other ways. We could go to like the Nether, which sounds I don't want to go there. We could also do some blood magic stuff, I think. Yeah, and that sounds interesting. I really want to get into that stuff sooner or later, but we really should start getting established a bit further. Apparently someone said that some of the future quests are crazy, like you need to collect billions of stacks of items, so it's going to be really crazy. We need to start getting things sorted. And apparently I also made a terrible mistake. Early on we get a quest here, which we get a slime bucket, and that was one of the rewards, but I didn't choose that. I decided to go for the stupid reward bag, and that apparently saves a lot of time, because you can use the liquid slime bucket, place it down, a blue slime can spawn. You can use that, capture it using one of the Pokeball safari nets, and the safari nets like these, and then you can turn it into a spawner and spawn multiple blue slimes. And if you don't get that, well, then you're going to have to take the long route, and I think you have to use a sapling, one of these slime trees. We've got a slimy sapling there, and sometimes they produce some blue slime, and that just sounds really, really tedious. We probably should get that going straight away, get that growing, because that was a terrible mistake. I'm not too sure if I should like look back and see what reward bag stuff I got, trade that out for the liquid slime bucket. I'm not too sure. It depends on how crazy tedious it is. Apparently it's really crazy. Anyways, so we cannot get the knapsack just yet, and hopefully we can get into some of the cows and farming. I don't think we'll do that today. Maybe next episode. Today I wanted to work on a different project, but anyways, I've got to show you the progress here at the tree farm. It's just pretty cool what we've got going on here. So here we have the working tree farm. It's fully automatic, like we set it up before, except for I've moved everything here, and I've got this nice pathway here, and as you can see, this is gravel road, and this is an amazing block. Look at this, it's just beautiful. Oh, it's so perfect. It doesn't even look much like gravel. It looks very stone-like to me, and I think that's awesome. I was looking into the different stone blocks here, and there are some really cool-looking ones. Look at these. These are all different types. I've got one type there, and one type here, and we've got the gravel road there, and it's awesome. So that is pretty cool. So here's the kind of concrete bridge thing here. Now I've got this strange box, and I'll show you what that is in a minute. And right here, I've been messing around with the micro blocks. So I've been turning these gravel roads into like panels, and then turning those panels. We can get the panels, then we can turn it into like poles and all sorts until you get down to notches and slabs and other stuff. So that's crazy. The micro blocks is really insane. Apparently we can make blocks with holes in them to allow item ducts and other things to go through. That was I think Niels pointed that out for me, so that's cool. Also, Alright, so I better go over how this is all working. So we've got our harvester here, which is great. Instead of getting the output here, I've actually got it up top. And that actually works, so you don't have to worry about this hole in the back. I'm not too sure what it's supposed to symbolize there, but this seems to work. We're getting the items being pulled out here into the barrels, which is great. Now, I set it to share leaves mode a little while ago, so we can collect up some collect up some leaves. And I've been funneling all these leaves out into all these barrels here to get more and more of this dirt. Precious, precious dirt. So that's another way we can get loads of dirt. When we share leaves, we get a ton, and we don't even need to supply it with any shares or anything. It will actually share it without the usage of shares. So that is great, and that is super duper useful, so we can get a lot of dirt right here. That is going to be crazy. So, here I've got the fluid duct, which is sucking out all the sludge. And I've got a little tank there. I can allow it, turn it on and off so that the sludge can stay here or go down into this box here. And this box is where it's getting sorted out. The poison and hunger fix, I found out that only affect in a, like a 9x9, I think it's 9x9, or is it, I'm not too sure, I need to count 3, no, it's 7x7. It's a 7x7 room here that if we go into, it will start poisoning us and giving us hunger, if it's got sludge in there at least. If there's nothing in there, okay, there's nothing here, so we're all good at the moment. But yeah, the sludge that comes into here through the fluid ducts, as you can see, is also getting, oh no, oh dang it, shouldn't have gone in the box. Alright, get out of the box, get out of the box. Oh no, oh wow, that was, okay, come on, get out, okay, that's bad. Alright, so we've got it getting powered, and we also have the item ducts coming out into this chest here, and this is where the output is, and we've got a lot of cool things here. We've got some more dirt, some sand, gravel, netherrack, soul sand, mycelium, clay, heat sand, peat, tainted soil, salt. We've got all sorts of crazy things, and I think there probably is even more stuff that can come out of this thing here, which is incredible. I'm also thinking about, like, I've got it set up like this so I can possibly expand it with more sludge boilers if I ever need to. Like, if I want more of these types of farms here and want to expand this out, get different types of trees, that would be great. So that is what this is all about. And it's all being powered by these energy generators and energy cells here, so that's cool. And that's what I've been busy doing, so I think that's going to be great. So this is what we've got here. And maybe we can extend this further out, get some more of these farms, which would be awesome. So today's project, we are going to continue along the quest book here. But it's going to be, oh, this quest here I haven't finished. Precision sledgehammer. Alright, let's quickly make that. I believe this hammer allows us to see the areas affected by these machines here. So we need two sticks and some plastic, which we should have, maybe in there. We have the sticks at least, but we don't have any plastic. I think I have some cooking up, so we can quickly grab some of those and make that hammer. Come on, come on. I want to do this nice and efficiently. Okay, that's great. Okay. Wow. Alright, very unorganized here, and very disorganized, I should say. And there we are, we've got the hammer, and we should be able to complete that quest. Oh, we can pick a reward bag. We'll go number 3. Woohoo! Nice. Very cool. And, should we open it? What type of reward bag it? Oh, it's a greater one. Oh, these reward bags are getting good. I'm liking it. Okay, very cool. Alright, let's just store some of these things away that I don't need on me. So I might give this a go, and we can have a look at how that works, but we'll open this. And we've got a Morvi decor reward. We've got some lapis bricks, obsidian bricks. I guess that could be nice for building, but not the greatest in the world. Oh, we've got a safari net. It's a mystery. Oh man, I don't want to know what's in some of these, because there could be some really, really crazy mobs stuck inside of them. Alright, anyways, we've got this hammer here, and if we hold it, we can see the area affected. Oh man, whoa, that's, okay, it's kind of going crazy here because of the planter. The planter's also got an affected area as well, so Let's see here. The planter seems to be coming out a little further out this way here. And so we can hold this and see the areas that these machines, all the mine factory reloaded machines work in. So we can clearly see that this harvester here is doing all the yellow, I do believe, and the green would be the planter, I think. I think that's right. I'm not too sure. One last thing, I need to show you this stuff. Red net cable from the Mine Factory Reloaded mod as well. This is awesome. It's basically redstone dust that attaches itself to this stuff. I was looking for something like this. What reminded me of this stuff is the Red Power mod, which has all sorts of crazy redstone gadgets and stuff, which is not in this mod pack, however, but I needed something like that so I could power all of these item ducts at once to filter all the dirt out. And I found red net cable, which seems to do its thing quite nicely, and you can attach a lever straight onto it, so that's pretty cool. Anyways, today we are going to make a digital storage system. Oh yeah. And that is part of another quest not along here. Oh, moving power. Oh man, we've already got most of that complete. Nice. And we've got some, okay, we could go for that maybe at a later stage. Anyways, I believe it was the For the Hoarding section here that we have a new quest here, Digital Storage, which sounds awesome. We can claim this too. Let's choose a reward bag. Number 2. Yay, it's probably going to be a really suck reward bag, a basic one, of course. So we're going to get some nutmeg saplings. Yeah, great. Not the greatest. They're pretty suck, but that's okay. Alright. Now, Digital Storage. So this is part of the Applied Energistics mod here, and we have the ME system here, which converts our items into digital storage, so we can store them like on a computer, and then we can automatically take stuff out like from anywhere. We could hook this up to our storage system, and it could be transferred wirelessly. I'm not too sure. I don't know. And then I think someone said something about a remote where we could access our storage system at any time. Not only that, we can do things like automatic crafting inside the system. It sounds amazing. So I really want to set this up, and we need to find a good space for it. And as I said before, all of our crazy non-farming machines are going to be probably underneath here. So like we've got this system here and all of that. So I think right underneath the island could be perfect. Because, you know, this is where we started, so if we die, we can quickly come back down here, and we'll have our storage system, even though you could probably access it, wirelessly and other things, so that would be awesome. So, I want to expand this out. I think we'll keep with the same floor pattern here. This floor will probably be like a big factory-like floor, and we'll maybe make a big area underneath here so we can begin work on our system here. Actually, let's take this life. Ding! 9. 9 lives. That's awesome. We're a cat now. Alright, anyways. Let's get all of these items, expand this place out, and begin working on our brand new storage system. Alright, so I have got all these things now. Man, they are crazy to make. I'll just show you. So all these items I've got, I can collect our things. Woohoo! We get 2 full hearts. I think that was totally worth it. Oh yeah, 11 lives. Okay, and the thing is, these things were so crazy to make. I'll show you. So this here is the crafting terminal, which you need to make these 2 things here. We know everything else. We've got workbench, iron, and glass. So we've got an access terminal here, which you need some of this stuff, which you need a cable, which means you need this type of dust, this fluix dust? I'm not too sure. Which you need nether quartz dust, certus quartz dust, and redstone. We get those from our ore production system there, but if we take a little look at that again, okay, then we have to get nether quartz dust, which means we have to pulverize that, and there's just so many different things you have to make. Look at all of that. We need to get all of this, and you get that from smelting this, which you make from all of this. Oh, it was just crazy, and there are still a lot more things we can do with this stuff here. I'm just going to make a basic system to start off with, because I have no idea what the heck I'm going to be doing. So, I believe we can place down our controller. This is what's going to control everything. So, I've got this area here, and I think right smack in the middle should be good enough. Yeah, that's good. Kind of the central area here, that's very nice. Okay, and I believe we need to power this. It uses different types of energy, and I don't know what kind of energy. I don't know if the redstone flux that is held in here will work, but we'll give it a try. Okay, let's put that in there, and I don't know if that will work. We might have to like convert it or something. Oh wait, I have to set this to output mode, right? Okay, it seems to be powered. It says 0 out of 64 megajoules, but I'm not too sure. It seems to be powered. This seems to be lighted up, and it says there it's got some energy stored in it. This seems to be going down, so it seems to be working, I think. Let's actually get a few ender pearls in this so that we can continue running this for some time. We will have to set up a good supply of power using these ender generators. It's a good temporary energy source for the meantime. But anyways, we've got our controller here. So, okay, we can do some stuff there. There doesn't seem to be much I can do right now. Let's install the other things here. So we've got a crafting terminal. I think we can place that on top. Oh yeah, okay. What just happened there? It just like loaded in or something? Okay, this is awesome. Very cool sort. Very cool, and we can craft things here. This is really cool. This is an awesome thing here. All right, and we need to get our drive. All right, can we place that right there? Oh yeah, I think that worked. Yeah, I think that did work. Okay, actually, just in case, this can only hold up to a certain amount of drives here, so we might want to expand that out. I'm not too sure if this will work. Would that work? Oh, I think it did. Okay, okay, ooh, I'm doing something, guys. We've got some cable here, the ME cable, and we make it with some of this, and we can also use plastic too. Very cool, and we get extra. Oh, I didn't see these extra recipes here. Very cool. Right, now I think we can install our drive here. I've got one drive here which has 1024 bytes. Okay, let's put that in. Okay, we can right click, put that in, and I think that's how it works. Okay, storage priority. Okay, I have no idea how to use that. Anyways, can I just, I don't know. Okay, this is, I have no idea if this is going to work or not, but let's just put in some wood, and oh, I think it just stored some wood. Okay. Yep, that worked. I think that worked. Woohoo! So now we can store things in here, and we can take it out, convert it back to matter, put it into the computer, and that is pretty awesome. So that's the system running there, which is very cool. Doesn't need to use too much power, which is great. We don't need to have anything too crazy. So there are some other things we can do with this to upgrade the system even further. So if we look at our quest book here. Alright, next up, oh man, we have got all of these other quests here. Look at this here. Punch tree, get blisters. How much freaking wood do we have to get? 100,000 logs. That is crazy. What kind of crazy quest is this? Oh my gosh. And 100 pistons. Let's see here. Oh, one endstone. Okay, we could get that somehow. I don't know how. One quadruple compressed dirt. Okay. And automated mining. Oh, that sounds interesting. Hmm. Okay. We probably should get another way of, we should probably upgrade the system even further. And let's see here. We've got, assemblers and stuff. Very cool. I don't think I really need to do this all yet. I don't feel like it's necessary to do that. But I do want to... I'm not too sure. Alright, what else should we do with the system? I think what we should also do is try and set up a way to wirelessly do this. I'm not too sure. That could be really difficult to set up. I have no idea what the heck I'm doing. So maybe I should continue along with this and try and attach all these weird things to it. Oh, man. Alright, guys. I think we'll leave the digital storage at that. That is the most complicated thing ever. I don't want to get it too complicated. There are a lot of other things that we need to make for that. And yeah, it's going to get crazy. I don't think I need all of this just yet too, even though this will be super useful later on. Like auto crafting and stuff. That would be super duper useful later on with those other quests. But for now, I think we should go back to the farming and such. Now what I've done is I'm starting to farm some of these slime trees, as you can see. We've got this beautiful blue slime tree here, which looks really cool, and it has this weird sound. Look at that. Oh, weird. And then we can break these, and it makes the slime sounds, which is awesome. And we break those, these are the trunks here, and we can convert that into slime balls, which is awesome. And these things here will break into some more saplings, as you can see, and it also drops blue slime balls occasionally. So that's how we're going to get our blue slime balls. It's going to be a tedious way to get them, but that's the only way we can get them at the moment. So there is, we got to check out our greater reward bag. And we got some elevators. Oh, how useful. Because I was actually going to make some a little later on, but they're pretty easy to make, but whatever. Let's actually install these in. This would save a lot of time. So what we can do is we can set one up. Maybe where's a good spot for an elevator? You think right there? I think maybe, I'm not too sure. Maybe right here, all right? Oh, okay, that's a bad spot. Here. I think that's also, oh, no, that could be okay. We install that there, and then we can install one down here. Directly underneath that, I believe, and we break this, and then what we can do is if we sneak, I have no idea how we use this. Oh, okay, we jump on it to get up, and we sneak to go down. Okay, I see. Ooh, that's awesome. So those are going to be very useful. I can go up very easily now, don't have to even climb up this ladder. Woohoo, I could just go up and down this thing all day. Yay! Okay, that's enough. Alright, let's actually get back up top. Now I wanted to start doing a bit more crazy farming. So, yeah, I am... this is gonna be crazy. So I've got a bit of dirt here, and I believe there's an easier way for all of this. It's called a builder's wand. I don't know... is there a mob? No, okay. It was just me. Okay, I believe you can make it like this. Yeah, awesome. It's part of extra utilities. I have no idea how to use it, but apparently you can use it to build out things a lot easier. So I have no idea how the heck... Okay. I would like it to be dirt, so can I... Oh, look at that. Oh, isn't that incredible? That is going to save me so much time placing blocks. Oh, yes. Yeah, okay. So now I want to set up a big, large field here for all of our other crops, like maybe some of our wheat and carrots and such. We're going to make a huge one. I think it's going to be maybe 24, 25 by 25, I think. And I'm going to have one plant and harvest in the middle, and we'll upgrade it to like the diamond upgrade, or is it emerald? Can't tell. Anyways, so I'm going to build this field out. I also want to make a large grassy area so we can start getting some animals and such. And I believe the best place, well, the place I've chosen is out here, over here. And what biome is this? This is a plains biome, which should have some, alright, grass. What's over here? We've also got another biome, just a little off. Okay, let's build out here. Builder's wand. Do your thing. Oh, we can do it like that. How do I build out like vertically here? I'll just build out kind of like this. Okay, and let's see what biome we're in now. Come on, we're in a jungle biome. Ooh, that could be interesting. We could get some ocelots. That could be really cool. So what I'll do is I'll make a large grassy area there. We're gonna need a lot of dirt, that means. Hopefully this is enough. Yeah, this is probably not going to be enough. I really will need to harvest a lot more dirt, and I'm going to try and finish this off, and maybe that grassy platform, and we'll see. Well, we're gonna have ocelots for days here. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I think we need to move this grass platform over there, a bit more towards the plains biome, over here, because that is a lot of ocelots. Man. Oh, I'm never gonna need this many. Alright, anyways, let's jump over here. And now with all this grass, oh look, they're all so scared. Maybe to the point where they'll commit suicide. Wow. Crazy. I think they did. Oh my gosh. Okay. Anyways, we can now grow some of this stuff and we get all sorts of weird things here. We've got cherry saplings. What's this? Wild cotton. Wild blueberries. Oh, it's so awesome here. And then we just right click, left click, and oh yeah, look at that. That's nice. And we get all these crazy things here. So that's going to be great. And we can start more farms. I've also got a sugarcane farm going on here. I needed that because I want to make this item. It's a new type of workbench which should come in very handy with all this, especially the applied energetic stuff. That's what I've been trying to accomplish here. I want to get this workbench which should help in the crafting of a lot of these things. So I think it's called, let's just search for a workbench. Oh look, here we are. Wow, that's the only workbench? Okay. So it's made using some paper, some tin, copper, and it's called the Machinist Workbench from the Thermal Expansion mod. So let's go get that stuff and make it. Do I have the paper? Where did I put my paper? Oh good, I have some. Phew, okay. So let's get some copper and tin and other stuff. Okay, let's make it. Here we are. The Machinist Workbench, and this is an amazing workbench. Okay, let's go to choose a good place to put this down. Let's put it over here by all of our stuff over here, and boom, it's owned by me. And now this is really crazy. Look at all of this stuff here. So first off, we need to make a schematic, and let's see here. How do we make one of those? Oh, here we are. All right, what's the recipe? Some paper and some dye. Okay. Blue dye. Can we use lapis? I wonder if we can use that. Let's give that a go. So we've got paper and lapis. Oh, beautiful. So we can create these schematics here and we can put them in. So I think we can do that. I think something like that. And for things that I constantly make, for example, a machine frame is something I always make. So we might want to make one of those. I need the iron and gold first of all. Let's get that. Iron. Where's all my gold? Wow. Okay, I think it's in here actually. I've started moving things out. Okay, let's grab that and make a... Wow, not very prepared. Alright, and make that machine frame. So we do that. Very cool. And that's what we do here. It actually doesn't use any of the resources, as you can see right here. It's all red because we don't have the items there. What we do is we put them in here. And then it lights up, so that's pretty cool. And then we can create multiple ones of these, and we can write this as write schematic. Very cool. Now we have a machine frame, and what we can do is we can just get rid of all that. Yes. And we've got this here, and it flashes. I was worried there. I thought it said it started turning into machine frame randomly. All right, and we put that in. And we can say set crafting grid from schematic. We get that, and then we can make these, and it will use these items. So if we make one, as you can see, it uses that, and it says there's not enough iron, so we get more iron and put it in. So that saves me a ton of time. I can make a lot of those schematics, and that was kind of a waste of, you know, we've got an extra machine frame there, but whatever. So that's pretty cool. Very awesome indeed, and that's going to save me some time. We might get into some more of this next time and look into how this works. What's the strange blue and green stuff here? I'm not 100% sure. I think it's how many items and different types there are. I'm not 100% sure, but it's pretty cool nevertheless. So I might look into some more of these stuff here and work on this farm there and that farm over there. And wait, is that a pig? Oh my gosh, I think I saw a pig. Oh my gosh. We might have our first ever animals. Oh, okay. Wait. Get up the ladder. Oh, we have an elevator right here. Right, silly me. Oh my gosh, we've got to keep this pig. We cannot lose our first ever pig. We have our first ever animal. Woohoo, welcome. We should name him. Or her. Ah, awesome. Anyways, hope you all enjoyed. I'll be busy, and I'll see you all in the next one. Take care. Yo, guy. I just... chill out, man. I know this is like a zombie thing and you want to kill me and all, but... you know, you just gotta learn to relax. Hey! No, not cool! I told you to relax! Oh, dang!